Even though I have a long history with Basecamp, the automatic check-ins tool was the feature I used the least before working here. And now, automatic check-ins is one of the Basecamp tools I probably use the most. If you're not yet using it or you're not quite sure how it works, this video is for you. I'm Kimberly from Basecamp's customer success team, and I'm going to show you how to add automatic check-ins to a Basecamp project. I'll also walk you through creating and editing automatic check-ins, and because we're all about sharing around here, I'll even show you how we use automatic check-ins here at Basecamp and how you might use them to streamline your work and take some of those dreaded meetings off your calendar. First, you'll need to add automatic check-ins to your project, and you can do that with a three-dot menu at the top right of your project page. Select Change Tools, and then you'll toggle Automatic Check-ins on. If you want to rename the tool, you can do that here. Now, before I show you how to set up and work with automatic check-ins in your Basecamp project, I think we should talk about why you might want to use them. I love how we describe them in our help guide. Automatic check-ins are for asking your team recurring questions and gathering their answers all in one spot. In many cases, we see automatic check-ins replacing daily or weekly stand-up or status meetings. Just because you need to know what everyone is working on doesn't necessarily mean you have to have a meeting to do it. Automatic check-ins are a really simple way to collect information consistently, keep your team up to date, or just get to know your colleagues better. To get started, you'll open the automatic check-ins card and click New Question. You'll type in the question you want to ask and then select when you want the question to be posed to your team. You have lots of options here. You can choose to ask the question daily, several times a week, once a week on a certain day, every other week, or even just once a month. You can also choose what time you want the question to be asked. We've given you two standard times, either the beginning of the day at 9 o'clock a.m. or at the end of the day at 4:30, but you can also designate your own time if you prefer. Now, keep in mind that people receiving the question will get it at their local time. So if you have people working in different time zones, you'll receive the answers back to their question at different times as well. The last step is to choose who should be asked your question. You can select everyone on the project with one click, or you can pick and choose who should get the automatic check-in. When it's time, Basecamp will send a notification to everyone on the list, asking them the designated question. Each person can click on the notification in their Hey menu, answer the question, and move on with their day. Just like in other parts of Basecamp, you can at mention someone, include attachments, or even link to other parts of Basecamp, which is really helpful when you want to point out where someone can get more information about your check-in. Within the automatic check-ins tool, you'll see everyone's answers saved in one place. And if anyone has a question or comment about someone's check-in, the Discuss button allows for any communication to happen right there on the check-in. If you're wanting to get a glimpse into someone's check-ins over time, that's easy to do. With the automatic check-in question open, go to the three-dot menu at the top and select See Someone's Answers. From there, you can choose someone on the list and see all their answers to that check-in consolidated in one place. You can easily edit the automatic check-in from that same three-dot menu. From here, you can change the frequency, the timing, and who is being notified. You can also change the question in this area, but just know that the answers that have already been submitted to the original question will stay with that check-in. So if you change the question completely, those answers won't necessarily make sense. You'd probably be better off just making a new check-in altogether. If you want to put a check-in on hold, you can click Stop Asking This Question at the top. That will stop the check-in from going out, but won't delete it completely. You can start it back up again at any time with one click. Now, if you want to completely delete a check-in along with any responses, you can do that by selecting Put in the Trash. Automatic check-ins help keep everyone informed without needing more meetings or tons of back and forth emails. It also helps keep everything on the record for future reference. But if you don't need to be notified when other people complete a check-in, you can go to the three-dot menu and change your notification settings. Here at Basecamp, we use automatic check-ins in a few different ways. Every Monday morning, the entire company gets asked, "What did you do this weekend?" It's completely optional to answer, but it's a great way to learn more about our coworkers. It's always fun to see who went on a cooking spree and to find out where in the world Michelle is currently working from. Monday mornings, we also get the question, what will you be working on this week? Each person chimes in with what they have planned on their to-do list over the next few days, and everyone else has full transparency to those plans. Each afternoon at 4:30, we get the automatic check-in, what have you worked on? This is where we report on what has been filling up our time, and everyone answers this question at least twice a week. I love this combination of check-ins because it really makes you self-monitor your work by saying what you're planning on doing at the beginning of the week and then checking in on those things throughout the week. Definitely helps you keep on task. And as a completely remote company, we're never wondering what someone else is working on, and we don't have to have a meeting to find out. I hope you'll give automatic check-ins a try. And as always, if you have any questions, just reach out. You can always get help from our team with that question mark in the bottom right corner of your screen.